Still life painting is a celebration of material pleasures such as food and wine. Hey budding artist, this is Aishwarya Bharat and I welcome you to Ayad Studio.
Food is paired with wine to enhance the dining experience. In many cultures, wine has had a long history of being a staple at the dinner table. The wine seems to enhance the food's flavors on your tongue. Finding the right combination of these elements will make the entire dining experience more enjoyable.
So today, using a palette knife, I'll guide you through the process of painting this wine and cheese still life art. Check the description below for the materials required. I'm sketching the wine bottle in a cylindrical shape. These measurements are very important in sketching. The still life will look realistic when sketched as per the proportions. The vertical line in the middle of the glass will make sure whether the outline drawn is of perfect size or not. I have drawn the cylindrical oval in the middle to show the level of wine in the glass. Wine bottle and the glass are rested on a wooden table. We shall later add some fruits and cheese on it. We also have elements like the wine bottle and the glass in the foreground and a velvet screen in the background, which creates a vintage look. There is a label on the bottle which has details about its brand. You can now take a screenshot and have this print out as your reference image. As the next step, using a palette knife, I take raw sienna for the bottle cap. For the shadows, I'm taking traces of sap green and highlighting it using titanium white. Mixing sap green and bit of black for the sides and bottoms of the bottle, and pure sap green for the middle. This is done to bring out the light and shadow effect in this painting. Make sure you create a textured effect using the knife wisely. Now we begin to highlight the portion of the bottle where light falls. By mixing some white with viridian green, we bring a lively effect. For the label, I applied white and then taking the same raw sienna we used for the cap and moving in horizontal strokes and wipe off the excess paint. Now we move to paint the wine glass. I'm starting to apply deep cyan blue since the background screen is blue color, which will be reflected on the glass. I'm highlighting it with white where light falls. For the red wine, I'm using black for the shadow region and crimson for the middle of the glass. Again, the bottom of the glass is a mere reflection of the background velvet screen, so we paint blue. I use titanium white to mark the level of wine in the glass. Highlight the wine glass with white wherever needed. I don't want the wooden table to look empty, so let's sketch some cheese and fruits that goes hand in hand with the wine and turn this into a party scene. The corners of the still life painting will be usually dark, so we use black and brown to depict the corner darkness. and highlight with raw sienna in the middle. We shall paint the background velvet screen now, which is my favorite element. I'm using deep cyan blue here, but you can use colors like red or brown. We have to concentrate on the movement of screen being highlighted. So apply the paint in curve as if it is falling on the wooden table. Some areas of the screen will catch light, so we use deep white there. Now I'm taking a 1/2 inch flat brush to darken the screen with phthalo blue. You can use the reference image to paint the shape of the screen. It's the same pattern we sketched earlier. As the next step, we begin to paint the image in Pinot Noir's bottle. I have taken a small round pointed brush and using titanium white, I'm painting a man with a lot of beard on his face. We now write PT Spear. We begin to write the brand of the bottle, Pinot Noir, in the same style as it would be printed on the bottle. And the caption says, Pure Origin, Pure Principle. To add additional info, we write 2019 Murray Darling, Australia. As the next step, we are painting the wooden table using Van Dyke Brown and Burnt Sienna. For the grapes, I use brown and crimson for the strawberries and cherries. We paint cheese cubes using yellow ochre and white. Create a textured effect on the strawberry by keeping dots from the corners of the knife. Sign it before winding up, and here is the still life painting of wine and cheese, painted with a palette knife, a perfect party setup. Do try this painting and tag me in Instagram and Facebook. See you guys next week with an interesting artwork. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe iArt Studio and hit the bell button for more contents. See ya!